In this video, our goal is to take a look at a relay, and we are going to learn all about these elements. Hopefully by the end you will have a pretty good understanding of what a relay is. Let's begin with, what is a relay? A relay is an electrically operated switch that usually designed to establish or interrupt low voltage control signal or bias signals only. Not high voltage, high current power input used to run an industrial motor. Relay contacts rarely switch loads directly, like motors or pumps, and only do this in the low power applications. Relays usually switch control signals, in other words, low power signals, to other low power devices, like the coils of the contactors or the solenoids of hydraulic valves. Devices like contactors or solenoids, when ordered to work by the control signal, they make the connection of heavy electrical or hydraulic power load. So, a contactor is the big brother of a relay. A relay also has a coil and the connected contacts. The main difference is, these contacts are usually rated for low voltage control signals only. Our next point is the applications of a relay. Relays are used in applications when it's necessary to control a circuit with a low voltage control signal, with complete electrical isolation between the control and the power side of the system, or where several circuits must be controlled by one signal. Relays can perform many functions and run a complex systems. Because a relay usually has available not only normally open contacts that close when the coil is energized, but also normally closed contacts that open when the coil is energized. These contacts can be used in electrically controlled systems to specifically energize or de-energize other elements in the system, or between two separate systems at the right moments to arrange the flow of a specific task. Now, let's have a look at the types of a relay. Relays come in many types. The two most common is the mini contactor relay, since it looks like a contactor, and the plug-in or ice cube relay, since it looks like an ice cube. Alright, our next point is the relay construction from outside. Ice cube relays come in many sizes, and it has a matching socket into which the relay fits. The base is hardwired to the system, and the relay can be removed for maintenance and troubleshooting purposes. Sometimes plastic hooks lock the relay into the base, and it must be unhooked for the relay to be removed. Be careful to not damage a plug-in relay when you remove it from a socket. The back of the base is usually fixed into a rail, like this. Okay. Now, what about inside construction? Alright, as you can see, a relay is consisting of a set of moving contacts, and it's making or breaking a connection to a load like a small motor or a lamp. These moving contacts are controlled by a low power control signal, and this low power control signal is electrically isolated and provided to the coil of the relay. Our last and most important point is the schematic symbol of a relay. For an industrial mini contactor relay, as we see here, this is the schematic symbol. These contacts are electrically isolated, and it's a single pole, single through switches. In the ice cube relay, this is the schematic symbol. These contacts are single pole, double through switches that share common terminal, as you see here, sometimes called C-form contacts or transfer switches. Can you see why they are called C-form contacts? Perfect. When one side is open, the other side is closed, and vice versa. Manufacturers sometimes use a single pole double through switch symbol to make the transfer function very clear to the user. That's it for this video. We will continue the relay in the next videos. See you then. Cheers.